As you know, Japan already has lower birth rate, lower marriage rate, and higher divorce rate. And now we are having this. This is trending the social media in Japan. I'm seeing many married people, especially women, complaining about their partner like this. Now, I'm sure not all of them are actually serious. But it's true, more and more married people are consulting a lawyer. According to a recent survey, 40% of the people are considering divorce. Some companies started to provide rental rooms for those people, hoping they can avoid divorce by that. Now, as you already know, this is happening in many countries, not just in Japan, which makes us really sad. But this time, as far as in Japan, let me share what I'm seeing here and my thoughts on that. More and more companies are shifting to remote work, and more and more married couples are forced to stay home and spend much more time together than usual. I think this is a big change, especially in Japan. It's quite common your workaholic husband comes back home always late at night, and you guys rarely spend time together at home. But maybe this means now you can have plenty of couple time, and that must be a good thing, right? I wish I could say that. We are seeing opposite case more, because you can see a behavior like this more often every day, and you are feeling more and more frustrated or disappointed. Especially, this is really common to see. And many women say it's totally unfair. So when it comes to this, there's a huge gap in Japan. It's kinda expected in the society. This is only mother's job. To be fair, Japanese men work much more than women, and do much more overtime work. We actually rarely see any men taking that in Japan. You see, many Japanese men are really not used to this, whether they are willing to do it or not. So even if they try to help their wife, sometimes she actually gets mad. It works oppositely. Some experts say like this, which I totally agree. Like I said, they are mostly company office and rarely at home usually. So I think many Japanese men also feel really stressed or frustrated as much as their wife. Some people are actually complaining like this. On top of that, this is happening to many people now. So you can see that their frustration and anxiety are piling up a lot. I'm actually really worried. We might have to see more incidents like this in the future. Probably a lot of companies are not gonna go back to normal yet. We have to continue this lifestyle more. But the thing is, even this aside, divorce happens a lot in Japan, which totally makes sense to me. In Japan, school and company start from April, so a lot of changes happen. And quite often, change causes stress. Actually, we have seen the same thing when this happened. The divorce rate went up a lot at that time also. And nowadays, this is getting common by the same reason. They actually rarely talk to each other when the husband working, and suddenly now, have to spend a lot of time together, which causing a lot of stress and frustration.
コロナが原因で離婚してしまうっていう方は、遅かれ早かれの話かなというふうに思うんですよ。ちょっと辛烈な意見になるんですけど、おそらくそのまあ数年間に離婚してしまうであろうご夫婦の方が、この期を境に離婚してしまったっていうだけの話なのかなっていうふうに思いますね。離婚生活を続けて行くのであれば、お互いの思いやりとか、まあ、モラルの部分大切になってくると思うんですけど、そういうことをこうお互いに意識できなかったっていうのが離婚の原因に直結してるとは思うので。
I think she's actually right. Maybe they are only married in name. And when you ask them why they got married, they probably answer like this. Actually, those married couples are not so rare in Japan. No wonder why they get divorced, right? So I guess the lesson we can learn from this is that we should get married to someone we can spend all day without feeling so much stressed. I know it may be quite difficult to find someone like that, but otherwise, we shouldn't get married in the first place. Having said that, it's not all negative. While many people are reconsidering their marriage, it's actually making some single people want to get married. Now they think having a partner is better when dealing with a crisis like this time. Also, some people stop cheating because of this pandemic. They couldn't see their cheating partner for a long time and finally realized cheating is bad. Anyway, I don't think it has to affect your marriage negatively. I'm sure some couples are still doing well, and I really hope that your relationship also is.
結婚するってことは長年この先何十年一緒にいるわけですから、冷めるじゃないですけど、お互いそばにいるのが当たり前にどうしてもなってきてしまうと思うんですよ。そういった時って、やっぱりお互い無理のない程度でルールを決めるんですね。 例えば結婚記念日とかそういった日は絶対に2人で食事をするとか、この日は大切にしようっていう、これだけは2人で守ろうねっていうルールですねを決めるっていうのは、お互いそこがこう軸となるというか、何があったとしてもこれだけは2人で大切にしようっていうものがブレなければ一緒にいれるんじゃないかなって思ってます。